name and read a lot about Polycarp. Polycarp was an evangelist who preached the goodness of God, who preached the gospel of Jesus Christ. And then they arrested Polycarp because of the name of Jesus Christ. Because he was just believing Jesus Christ. The Pope begged him to denounce Christ. And the Emperor begged him to denounce Christ. And at the age of 87 years, they arrested him and they brought him before the arena. And they were about to let loose the lions upon him to devour him alive. But then they gave him a choice. They said, you can avoid die. Even the Emperor pleaded with Polycarp and said, why will you die, 87-year-old man, just for the sake of the name Jesus? Why will you lose your life? Polycarp said, Polycarp looked upon them and he said, he has done me no wrong.
Amen.
Why should I deny him?
Yeah.
He has done me no wrong. Why should I deny him? And so they let loose the lions. And the lions were slow getting to Polycarp. 87-year-old man, he got up and he walked toward the lion and he pulled the mane of the lion and shook the head. He said, do what to do. You remember what Jesus said to Judas? What to do, do quickly. I'm ready. I'm willing. I'm able. By the power of God, what you are doing, do quickly. And so the shepherd gave, the good shepherd, sacrifices for the sheep. And because the man Polycarp realized that God Almighty, Jesus, sacrificed so much for him, he did not die in the name of Jesus Christ. So number one, the good shepherd sacrificed for the sheep. He makes all kinds of sacrifices. Number two is found in verse 14. This is where we come in.
Yeah.
In John chapter 10, verse 14, it says, I am, he repeats again, the good shepherd.
Yeah.
The good shepherd is not a stranger to the sheep. He said, I know my sheep, and I am known of mine. Does Jesus know your name? Does the Lord know your name? Is your name written in the Lamb's book of life? Are you saved? Are you filled with the Holy Ghost? Are you sanctified? Does he know who you are? Does he know you by name? When I go to the marketplace, sometimes, in fact, my daughter lives in Miami, and when somebody met her, it's a lot of times she told me that people will look at her and they will say, are you Adewumi's daughter? And she will say, yeah, that's my daddy. Because they know her by who she belonged to. Brothers and sisters, they know you by who you belong to. Who do you belong to today? Who is he in your life? Whose picture do you bear? Everything bears a stamp. Made in Italy, made in China, made in Korea, made in Taiwan. Even the phones we carry, made in the USA. But whose stamp do you bear? Whose stamp is on your life? Does Jesus know your name? Does he know who you are? And so number two, the number two point is that the good shepherd knows his sheep. And not only that, now he says, now the sheep know him. The sheep know him. They can come with all kinds of philosophies these days. I just passed a so-called church about a mile up the road. It's called church, and I said they ought to take that name church out of that sign, because it's no church who said they don't believe in God. It's not a church who does not believe in Jesus Christ. It is Jesus Christ who calls the church. He said, I will build my church, and the gates of hell shall not prevail against it. And so when I get a chance, and I know some people there, I will recommend to them to take that name church out of that building.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
They can go name it mosque, they can name it temple, they can name it anything else.
Yes, sir.
Because Jesus, nobody has a right to be called church who does not know Jesus and who is not known by Jesus.
Yes, sir.
It says in verse 14, I am the good shepherd. I know my sheep. Everybody claims to belong to Jesus, but Jesus Christ said, I know my sheep. Jesus Christ. In fact, the Bible says, let all who love the Lord depart from a iniquity. The Lord knows them that are his. The Lord knows them that are his. Let all who know the Lord, let all who profess the Lord depart from iniquity. I know my sheep, and my sheep knows me. They know me. He said, I am known by my sheep. How do we say that? When it's not by how we dress alone, it's not by what we say alone, it's not by the bumper sticker on our car, but by who lives on the inside, who dwells on the inside. That is how we are known. When we are driving by at night and the light is shining bright in here, somebody passing by will have no problem saying there's somebody in that building, there's somebody in that house, because the light is shining. And when Jesus, the light of the world, he dwells on the inside, the light will shine on the outside. And Jesus, the good shepherd, when we know him, we ought to make sure that he knows us, that we are not just professing him, but he knows us who we are. So let me recap. Number one, the good shepherd sacrificed his life for the sheep. And if we are not willing to sacrifice for the sake of someone else, then it calls our devotion to question. If we are not willing to sacrifice an extra hour to go out and reach out and tell somebody that the gift of God is eternal life, if we are not willing to lay down, leave our convenience and go out and inconvenience ourselves for the sake of Christ, it calls our faith to doubt. Number two is that Jesus knows his own,
yes, sir,
and his own know him.
Yeah.
We all here know Jesus.
Yeah.
Have we been known by him?
Yeah.
Jesus is the good shepherd.
Yes, sir.
He is the good shepherd.
Yeah.
There are bad shepherds. But Jesus is the good shepherd. The good shepherd lays down his life for his sheep. Hallelujah.